Hey guys, Matt from SoundRolling.com. I want to do a video today about gear and why you don't have to necessarily buy all your own gear. There's definitely different times and places to do it. My career path wasn't just buying everything straight away. On my last video I did, I told you the three main ways that I did actually buy the gear. Got a few dislikes, and so I'm assuming that that is in relation to buying gear is the only way to have a successful career in sound. That is not true at all. The bonuses, I guess, of buying gear is that it's yours. It's always with you. You can charge rental for it, and so you're not necessarily making more money, but you're at least sustaining the amount of gear that you have because of things like upgrades or repairs or insurance. It's kind of just paying for all of that. So a common, misconception is that gear rental is actually part of your physical day rate and income. Day rate is separate from gear because gear has its own costs and expenses and expendables. So the downsides, the downsides are obviously just the investment, the initial investment and outlay, because that's not going to other things like rent or things like that. It can get very, very expensive very, very quickly, and so it can be hard to try and get quite a lot at once. So for instance, Electrosonics is like £10,000 or something for like the four sets of mics. And wireless packs, and that's not even buying the microphones to go on them. And so if you did something like hire purchase, it wouldn't be something that you want to rush into, because obviously then you have to have that commitment, and if you can't keep up that commitment with the amount of work that you have, then obviously that's going to cause you some trouble as well. So then the bonuses of renting or hiring in are that you hire exactly what you need when you need it. You're still obviously getting the hiring paid for, so it's just all about your day rate. And again, maybe you have part of your equipment that's actually kind of already bought or included in that. And so then you're just topping up extras. So things like wireless packs are a perfect example. And that's one of the things I did early on. I had, before I even bought a couple of G3s, I was just renting those kind of things out and trying to just flesh out my kind of core kit in terms of recorder, well, shotguns first, to be honest, because the recorders were quite expensive. But it also means that you have the flexibility to do any job, because if I need a 12-channel mixer or something, then I can just rent a 12-channel mixer. If I need a live desk, then I can rent a live desk, and then you're not shelling the outlay of things like insurance and other things like that, because that's already covered by production. So it can actually keep your costs really low and make sure you're flexible. Of course, the downside as well is potentially not having those things available, so you do need quite a lot of sources to be able to rent from. But that's just my thoughts about making sure that there's not people out there that think buying gear is the only way to do it. It's obviously a very nice thing to have, and you can make some extra money, and things do pay for themselves, because generally gear is about 1% of its value as day rate. So in technically 100 days of working, you should be able to pay pretty much anything off. So that basically means that whatever you buy, or at least in my experience personally, pays for itself and more. Obviously then minus some actual upkeep and things like that. But generally 100 days a year, and then I've basically paid off the full value of it. So if anything did happen, obviously usually fixing things like that would be less expensive than buying a whole new thing. So yeah, that's just my thoughts on that. Let me know in the comments down below whether you like or dislike this video. The most important thing is the comments. So till next time, see you later.